Welcome to a lesson on the existence and uniqueness of an initial value problem in the form of y prime equals f of x comma y with initial condition y of x sub 0 equals y sub 0. We want to ask two fundamental questions about the problem. Number one, does a solution exist? And number two, is the solution unique if it exists? To help us answer the question, we can use Picard's theorem on existence and uniqueness, which states if f of x comma y, which is given by y prime, is continuous as a function of two variables, and the partial of f with respect to y exists and is continuous near the point x sub 0 comma y sub 0, given by the initial condition, then a solution to the initial value problem exists, at least for x in some small interval, and is unique. It's also important to note that if the first condition of Picard's theorem is met, then there is a solution, we just don't know how many solutions there are. Meaning, if f of x comma y is continuous near x sub 0 comma y sub 0, then a solution exists. Again, we just don't know how many solutions there are. So to apply Picard's theorem, we'll first check to see if f of x comma y is continuous near x sub 0 comma y sub 0, and then we'll check to see if the partial of f with respect to y is also continuous near the point x sub 0 comma y sub 0. However, if f of x comma y is not continuous near the point x sub 0 comma y sub 0, we can stop because there is no solution. Let's look at some examples. Let's attempt to solve y prime equals 1 divided by x with the initial condition y of 0 equals 0. Actually, let's first apply Picard's theorem to see if there is a solution, and if there is a solution, if it's unique. Which means the first step is to check to see if y prime equals f of x comma y, which in this case is 1 divided by x, is continuous around the point 0, 0. Notice how I labeled the function f of x, y, but it's really just a function of x in this case. And it's pretty easy to see here that f of x equals 1 divided by x is undefined at the point 0, 0, because when x is 0, we have division by 0. Since f of x, y is not continuous around 0, 0, a solution does not exist at 0, 0. But let's go ahead and check the result by actually trying to solve the initial value problem. We know to solve y prime equals 1 divided by x, we integrate both sides of the equation with respect to x, which gives us y or y of x equals natural log abs of I of x plus c. Looking at the general solution, we know y equals natural log abs of I of x plus c is undefined at x equals 0, because natural log 0 is undefined, which verifies the initial value problem does not have a solution with the given initial condition. On this slide, we have the slope field for y prime equals 1 divided by x. In red, we have the graph of several particular solutions, none of which have the initial condition y of 0 equals 0, again, because y equals natural log abs of I of x plus c is undefined at x equals 0. Let's look at a second example. Here we're given y prime equals x times the square root of the quantity y minus 2 with the initial condition y of 1 equals 2. We're asked to determine if there is a solution, and if there is a solution, is it unique? So again, we'll apply Picard's theorem, where the first step is to check to see if f of x comma y equals x times the square root of the quantity y minus 2 is continuous around the point 1 comma 2, given by the initial condition y of 1 equals 2. Notice when x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2, we have 1 times the square root of 0, which is equal to 0, and therefore the function is continuous around the point 1, 2, as long as the y value is greater than or equal to 2. And therefore we can say f of x, y is continuous around 1, 2 if y is greater than or equal to 2. This means there is a solution. The next step is to check to see if the partial f with respect to y is continuous around the point 1, 2. So first we write the function as f of x, y equals x times the quantity y minus 2 raised to the 1 half power, and now we differentiate with respect to y, treating x as a constant, so we multiply by 1 half, and then subtract 1 from the exponent. This gives us 1 half x times the quantity y minus 2 to the power of negative 1 half, which equals x divided by the product of 2 and the square root of the quantity y minus 2. Notice now when y is equal to 2, we have division by 0, and therefore the partial of f with respect to y is not continuous around the point 1, 2. So because the first condition of Picard's theorem is met, but the second condition is not, there is a solution to the initial value problem, but it is not unique. To get a better idea what's happening here, let's take a look at the slope field for y prime equals x times the square root of the quantity y minus 2. The initial value problem actually has two solutions, which is why there is not a unique solution. First, we have the polynomial solution at the top. We also have the trivial solution, which is the constant function y equals 2. And now if we look at the slope field, the polynomial function is graphed in black, which we can see fits nicely in the slope field and passes through the point 1, 2, given by the initial condition y of 1 equals 2. But notice y equals 2 also passes through the point 1, 2, and when y equals 2, y prime is equal to x times 0, which is 0, and y equals 2 does have a slope of 0. So both of these are solutions to the initial value problem, which again is why we don't have a unique solution. And now let's look at one more example. Here we're given y prime equals x times y squared with y of 1 equals 2. And again, we're asked to determine if there is a solution, and if there is a solution, is it unique? So once again, we'll apply Picard's theorem, where to begin, we check to see if f of x comma y equals x times y squared is continuous around or near 1 comma 2. Well, when x is 1 and y is 2, notice the function value is just 1 times 2 squared or 4. This indicates f of x comma y is continuous around or near 1 comma 2, and therefore there is a solution. And now we'll check for uniqueness by determining if the partial of f with respect to y is continuous around or near 1 comma 2. The partial of f with respect to y is equal to 2 times xy. When x is 1 and y is 2, notice how we have 2 times 1 times 2, which is 4. This indicates the partial of f with respect to y is continuous around the point 1, 2. So because f of x, y is continuous, and so is the partial of f with respect to y around the point 1, 2, there is a solution to the initial value problem, and it's also unique. To get a better feel for this, let's once again look at the slope field given by y prime equals x times y squared. Here we have the point 1, 2, and there is only one function that fits nicely in the slope field and passes through the point 1, 2, which we could determine using separation of variables, which would give us y equals negative 2 divided by the quantity x squared minus 2. I hope you found this helpful.